men's singles final coming up next. Coming to you live from St Jakob's Halle here at the 2012 Swiss Open. Li Hyun-il, world number 7, seeded number 5 in this contest against Chen Jin of China, number 4. So it's going to be a big one. Chen Jin, world ranked number 5 in the world, 26 years of age from Hebei province in China. He's 181 centimeters tall, 72 kilos. Won this event in 2010 after defeating Chen Long. He also won this event in 2007, defeating Simon Santoso. This week in Basel, his semi-final, he took care of the Indonesian veteran Taufik Hidayat, 21-11, 21-18. In the quarterfinal, Darren Liu from Malaysia. In the third round, Jan Jurgensen of Denmark. And Ted Jorno from Indonesia in the second round. Boris Sayadut in the first. On some recent activities for Chen Jin. Second round loss to Hidayat at the All England last week. Third round loss to Wong Wing Ti from Hong Kong at the German Open Grand Prix Gold. And a semi-final, he retired against Kenichi Tago at the Malaysian Open earlier in January. Some career highlights, he won the Singapore Open after a walkover from Lin Dan. Won the 2010 BWF World Championships after defeating Hidayat in the final. He mentioned the 2010 Swiss Open Super Series defeating Chen Long in the 2008 All England Super Series defeating Lin Dan in the final. His opponent here today, Li Hyun-il of Korea, ranked number 7 in the world. Now having down his seed at number 6, but he is the number 5 seed here. A left hand up, he's 176 centimeters tall. There's quite a big difference in the height, 67 kilos. This week in Basel, yesterday in the semi-final, he took care of Chen Long, number 2 seed from China, 21-14, 21-19. In these quarter-final, he went up against Denmark's teenage sensation, Victor Axelsen. Axelsen playing some wonderful tennis, some wonderful badminton, I should say, throughout this season. That didn't reflect in the score, though, 21-15, 21-14. Third round, he took care of Xu Xiangyi of Chinese Taipei, and Dida Domka of Germany in the second round, and Sunny D from Portal from Indonesia in the first round. Well, the stage is set. We are just about set to get into our men's singles final. The number 4 seed, Chen Jin of China, taking on the number 5 seed, Li Hyun-il of Korea. Assisted by our service judge Ossibald. The 12th time these two have met before. Chen Jin leads in the head-to-head ranking 7-4. Their last time coming at the Korea Grand Prix Gold event in Hwasun last year in 2011. I was there. It was a wonderful match. Walking away the winner, 17-21, 21-13, 1. Looking a little bit lazy on that approach to that shot, just holding his racket out, not really giving much swing at all. speed though. That being said, tough shot for a turn. More than happy to take the point. 10-10 brought down to his knees. A bleeding shot again to that back corner, placing it all over the court. Chen Jin getting a workout early on. Wonderful example of Swiss precision right into the back corner. Through the motions, the big left hand smash. much play directed towards those rear and side lines in this contest. Looking for those outright winners. Just hesitating momentarily as that one flew by. He might have had a swipe at the very last moment. For you up-and-coming players watching at home, you certainly can learn a lot from these two on the center stage. Li Hyun-il in particular, his footwork is so clean. The edge of his toes more like a table tennis player. The rear of the table. Wonderfully sharp instincts, very quick with reaction time in all directions. Just waiting for that switching direction, but Lee keeping him guessing, holding that straight line, working away at that left hand side. We can see Chen just eager to get back to the center of that court, expecting that quick change, but it didn't come.
Directing it nicely, 11-5 in favour of Li Hyun-il at the break in the first game. The men's singles final here at the 2012 Swiss Open. Thank you. continues to hand these over. You can hear that support in the crowd. That's from Chen Jin. Of course, the Koreans dominating proceedings here last year. Singles, and I think Danish pair, Lady Petrul and Morgenson perhaps, quite come to mind, who took the mixed doubles final. Wonderful. Again, just holding that line very nicely, very straight. Right-hand corner, and then straight down the line. We've seen Chen Jin covering a lot of court. The sky. It's not Superman, it's Lee Hyun-il. Plenty of air time. Can't get it on the first one here. And he had the second chance. He was diving to his side, pulling it back. 14-7. And again, just taking away all the speed of the shot. Going more. That plan to place it. Okay, it's quite deceiving if we have a look. To the racket, that just wasn't going to carry the distance. Chen Jin hasn't really had a chance to do much from his serves. Two straight points is the most he's achieved so far. We've seen a string of six early on from the Korean. Gap caught out by the net. Gap closed to just 5 points. 10, 15. Well, Jim has spent a lot of time on the floor, on his knees, diving for these big overhead smashes. Winners just continue to add up. Again. perfectly played. Tianjin again reaching for the floor on two occasions, really finding himself on that back foot on the defensive side as Lee just continues to draw him around the court from one side to the other. And that last little shot, again, just the right touch. Forcing the big lift from Chen. And Lee, as we've seen so many times throughout this game, just hitting straight down that left line with the big left overhead shot. Chen just waiting for that switch in direction, but it still hasn't come on the majority of those shots. Lee, of course, not giving anything away with the approaches to those shots, just waiting for that last moment to decide on the direction, following through magnificently. Over towards our umpire in the chair, Schlieben. Thought it was out. There was no overruling coming. Back of the service, the line judge had a very stern look on his face. The Lee getting caught out on a number of occasions now. Those low shots, just trying to lift it back into play. Put the power on it, just ricocheting off the strings, the tension not enough to put it up and over. To say the least, 21-14. Lee Hyun-il, the number 5 seed, off to a brilliant start, claiming the first game in this men's singles final, the Swiss Open. Chen Jin will need to dig deep, try and build off the support he has in the crowd. 14-21, what's the score in the first? Lee Xiong-Yu playing brilliantly here. Just a couple of little mistakes coming, but it was all coming from trying to set up the winning shots. Playing a huge part. The shuttle just kissing the top of the tape before deciding to roll back down. Didn't quite continue over. To just put that one back. That backhand side just directing it away from his opponent. Lovely switch. His first point on the board in the second game. From Chen Jin. His head is really in the game now. He's incredibly focused. As he followed that one back, but almost bouncing on his toes in play. 5-1. Back here. 3-2, 3-5. was a little sharp. Lee really winding up the rear of his court.
7-3.
Easy points. Wonderful recovery from the ground, up as quick as lightning, retreating back. Oh, very quick. Read it well. Lee is really struggling now to try and put his tactics into use. I think Chen is pretty much on to his game here. In the past, it was Lee Hyo-il going into the break in the first with a convincing lead. I think it was about 11-4. See Chin Chin just doing much that here in the second game. And he does 11-3. He's the score at the break. Chen Jin, the number 4 seed from China, has really taken note of what his coach had to say between games. He's come out a new player, totally changed. Singles final decided in the third. Center of the court there. He's forcing Lee to push a little bit wider those shots. Not quite able to work him into position to open up that free court that we saw in the first. Those big long leading shots into the rear of the corner, trying to hold him on that left-hand side, that preferred side. Points from Chen Jin. Chen Hill. Trying to fight back.
Oh! Yeah!
That was a short-lived serve. Just one attempt. Thank you. Yeah, clears the entire court. To try and push the boundaries, but Hugh-Neil is being defeated by them. Still showing signs of class. Just drawing him in. This is what we saw so much of in that opening game. Bringing him in. Chen was quite quick to retreat back, but still didn't have any idea of the direction. Another one. Well, better late than never. Lee Cornelli starting to open up. Swinging freely.
17.
Sinjin can match the strength and power of a head.
As
he draws nearer and nearer towards those decisive points. 18-8. Only fitting with such an evenly matched up pair at the men's singles final. The outcome should be decided in the third. It's what the crowd would want. We only had one match yesterday going the full distance. 21-9. I thought 14-21 was convincing in the opening. Chen Jin has really lifted his game. He really is lifting his game here. See how they go when we return. The third final and deciding game of the men's singles final coming right up. Tianjin causing a little bit of a frenzy with his female admirers in the crowd as he changed his top between games, taking on board everything the coaches had to say. Li Chuyil, on the other hand, just standing solo. I think he very much knows what he needs to do. Try and revert back to those tactics from the first game and keep his opponent guessing. Tianjin, after the scoreline in the second, 21-9, he'll certainly hold the upper hand entering into the decider. Consecutive shots as soon as Chen's knee touches the floor. That's the indication for Li to heat things up a little bit. Start to the third, just as we've seen in most of all our games so far here. Again, just hugging the line. Lee decided to play anyway, but it's just slightly wide. 3 points all. Superb, absolutely superb. The crowd again on the edge of their seats throughout the rally. Let's have another look. Such a close contact. Wonderful switching direction, a little backhand net kill, just putting it a little bit deeper. 4-3. Down a little bit between points. Taking a moment to compose themselves, me in particular. Early rallies with a lot of confidence. Continues to move throughout. Footwork really helping his game. I'd have to say, he probably takes twice as many steps on the court as Chen Jin. He's constantly on the move, just dancing away. Here takes a moment to consult the line judge regarding the call. He certainly thinks that he was hard done by. A nod from the chair indicated that chair umpire agreed with the turn. After a second look there, it certainly looked to drop into play before bouncing out. Taking away a lot of the pace, going up strong, but dropping it forward. Just able to put his nose back in front at the point. Like that, Lee is not going to waste, just drilling that one down. Just pause for a moment as a few skills get wiped up on the court. There's both deserving a quick rest there. 8 points to five, Lee coming out super strong in this third game. Really serving well. Three consecutive points coming. And the edge. Quick correction of the score, 7-5. it looks like we're going to get back into this game here where the lines will count for so much. Accuracy, so important. I'd really like to see Lee Hyun-il try to put a little bit more on those little drop shots over the net. Maybe a bit more tumble, a bit more spin or something. Chin Jin taking no time at all to level the score. 7-all in the deciding. It's a deciding game. Plenty of height, really getting on top of the shot. Chin Jin has to be one of the taller players in the game. 81 centimetres tall, 5'11". Well, after holding the lead momentarily, a couple of points, Chen Jin is back in front, 8-7 serving. On it, just holding the racket out. Being held a long way back, his backhand returns from the rear of the court, forcing his back to face the net momentarily, just losing sight of the game. It wasn't that that gave the point away. It was Lee playing to the exact same spot, and the twisting back to get into that position, always difficult to reverse back. 9-8. Lee Hyun-il has the serve. Had a pretty convincing margin by the time we've got to this part. Won't be the case as we go into the next break. Oh, well, it is disappointing. Not following through, not swinging with the shot really at all. Just trying to direct it over the net. Such close play, not the right choice. 10-9, Chen Jin looking to serve us into the interval. And he does, 11-9. Well, we are set for a dramatic conclusion to our men's singles final. It's just what the crowd has craved throughout the week. A wonderful way to finish off the contest. Thank you. excitement building here in St. Jakobshalle in Basel, Switzerland. Final stage of this men's singles contest now. Highest remaining SIM players in the contest on the center stage. Shenzhen fighting hard in that second game. Convincing margin 21-9 after dropping the first 14-21. He holds a narrow lead, 11-9, serving as we come out of the break. The line. Always good to take the first point out of the break. Edging further ahead. Racing in. Drilling it to the floor. It was loose on the way up, and Lee is the last player to let those sort of things get away. Just charging into the net. Caught right back. He knew what was coming.
Dan Wall.
A little bit of work still remaining for Lee. 2 points is the difference. Going long before Chen decided to leave it. Now just exchanging tit for tat. 1 point here, 1 point there. 1 point the difference. 12-13, Lee has to serve. Stepping up to control the point in the latter stage again. That switch in direction was what started it off. Shenzhen clearly worried by it. He knew that he was on the back foot again. There was the first, there's the second. It was all over. And now all tied up. 13 points all in this third game. The crowd loving every moment. No one is going anywhere. Now, ice cream salesman has even sat down to catch the last of this game. Opening. majority of the support in the crowd overwhelmingly for the young Chinese player Chen Jin. Looks like she's been young, he's been around for some time now, 26 years of age. Sport has to offer from the rally. A nice short game on the net. Both players just matching one another, waiting for who will break first, who's going to lift and clear. Into play but just couldn't recover. That momentary lapse, he thought it was going, had to keep it alive, and well, it was a long way back to come forward again. Their fluids. Fatigue will certainly start to be kicking in at this stage. They've been on court now for 62 minutes of play. We are no closer to deciding our champion. 1 point separating our two players. Close to the net. Chen just lunging forward for the net kill. Just catching it inches above the top of the tape. Still enough to send it back down. 18-16. The story of the afternoon for Lee Hyun-il. The line often hampering his play. He has helped from time to time, particularly in that first game, but since then he's struggled. 19-16, two clear points is required for Chen Jin to claim the title. Boost he needed, and with that it is match point. Chen Jin from China serving for the title. 20-17 after 66 minutes of play. We haven't seen so many going the full distance this week in Basel. Lee has won every single one of his matches in straight games. Chen Jin has also done the same, has not dropped a game. His first one was the opening one of this 2017, serving for the title, Chen Jin of China. Disappointed Lee Hyun-il. The final score 21-17. Chen Jin has done it. 14-21, 21-9, 21-17. A wonderful achievement. The crowd getting exactly what they've craved throughout the week. A spectacular finish to the men's singles contest. Our award ceremony coming up very shortly. Coming up after that is going to be another highlight of the day. The women's singles final. Our reigning champion, number 3 seed from India, Saina Nawal, will take on the number 2 seed from China, Wang Xixian.
the men's singles. The Sieger L with Luigi Quirpo. The prizes are given by Daniel Stein, Philippines Organisation Committee, member of the organizing committee, and Martin Speiser, chef supporter for Rheinbuch. The Pokal gestiftet von the Tropical Sports by Gastechnik Werner Rahn. The Sackmesser gesponsert von the Nicer Sponsor by McDonald's.
Singles
Our
champions
Korea, from Korea.
Our runner-up, the number five seed, Lee Hyun-il. Fantastic showing throughout the week. And what a way to finish it off, coming right down to the wire. Presented by Daniel Stein.
Champion.
Well, our champion who needs no introduction whatsoever. The number four seed had a little bit of a slow start in today's final, but he got there in the end. Chen Jin of China, a worthy victor. A big congratulations. Well, as mentioned, coming up in a few moments' time, our women's singles final. Selena Nowal, the number three seed, taking on Wang Xixian of China, number two seed.